Untamed is the signature steel roller coaster at Canobie Lake Park in New Hampshire. Located in the far corner of the park, Untamed opened in 2011 as New England's first, and still currently only, Gerstlauer Euro-Fighter. Prior to adding Untamed, Canobie had quite the coaster drought. The park hadn't added a new roller coaster since 1991, and even that's debatable as it was the Dragon kiddie-powered coaster. The last time Canobie added an adult roller coaster had been the Corkscrew in 1987, which was a twice-relocated Arrow Corkscrew that previously ran at Old Chicago and the Alabama State Fairgrounds. So it was a big deal for Canobie to get a brand new roller coaster after a two-decade wait, and it was hard to find a better choice than the Gerstlauer Euro-Fighter. The Beyond Vertical Drop was a highly marketable element, and the ride's footprint was perfect for Canobie Lake Park. The ride's max height of 72 feet satisfied the park's strict height restriction. All rides at Canobie must be below the tree line or roughly 80 to 85 feet tall. And the coaster's compact layout fit within the boundaries of the park. Canobie redid the entire area around Untamed, calling it the Big Bear Plaza, and this area looks fantastic. It feels quite woodsy with the architecture and bear totems. And the area has only looked better with each passing year as the trees continue to grow back in. But the park also made an excellent choice for the ride's color scheme. The track is a faded green to match the nearby evergreens, and the white supports have markings similar to birch trees. That was a little touch Canobie didn't have to do, but was a really neat aesthetic to add to the ride, as this is a park that places a strong emphasis on appearance. And that also extends to the station. Untamed Station is gorgeous, as it captures the feel of a lodge deep within the woods. And then there are the trains. Each train is themed to have a grizzly bear in the front of the train, and the detail is fantastic. However, those trains are the biggest downfall with Untamed, in my opinion. While many of the newer Eurofighters have lap bar only trains, take Hydrus at Casino Pier for example, Untamed has over the shoulder restraints. And this is an issue for two reasons. One, the roughness. Untamed has some jerky movements that will cause head banging, so I often find myself leaning forward to mitigate that. This is something I don't have to do in the lap bar only versions, which allows me to enjoy the layout more fully when I'm not focusing on self-preservation. Two, the lack of freedom. The lap bar only trains make the airtime on the drop and hang time on the inversions even more pronounced. Now, my pipe dream would be for Untamed to one day receive lap bar only trains, but I know that probably won't happen because the park would probably prefer to invest that money into a brand new attraction. Part of that reason is because Untamed is definitely one of the park's most popular attractions. This ride typically has a shorter wait than the Yankee Cannonball, as I usually find it's a 15 to 20 minute wait. And if you're a single rider, you can board even faster since the ride has a poorly marked single rider line on the back side of the station. Because of how it's not marked very well, there usually aren't many people using it, which usually gets me on just a few trains most days. Once seated, you hear the roar of the bear as you're dispatched. You turn to the right and ascend the 72 foot tall vertical lift. I've been on my fair share of vertical lifts at this point, but this was once the first one I ever experienced. I remembered it being quite imposing, and it's really unique lying on your back like that as you climb towards the sky. When you reach the top, you slow down ever so slightly, and then are thrown down the Beyond Vertical Drop, which has an angle of descent of 97 degrees. And this drop has some amazing ejector airtime, even with the over-the-shoulder restraints. Untamed may have the best drop in New England. Yes, I think it may be better than the drops on Suitman or Wicked Cyclone. And the pullout from this drop is extremely intense, and one of the most underrated parts of the ride. Untamed pulls 4.5 Gs in this pullout, which is higher than most loopers you'll find out there. I don't usually gray out in this pullout because the Gs aren't very sustained, but you'll certainly feel them. That's followed by the vertical loop. This element doesn't really pack on the positive Gs, but you do get a pinch of hang time as the train sort of slows down atop the loop. That's followed by the cutback, and this is without a doubt the worst element on the ride. You enter the cutback with quite a bit of speed, and it's a pretty compact element, so you can really whack your head if you're not careful. It also doesn't help that the train shuffles quite a bit as it navigates this element. The following turnaround is a similar story. The train shuffles through it, and the tight turn can lead to even more headbanging. But it's not quite as bad in this element because you take it with considerably less speed than the cutback. But Untamed then returns to greatness with the inline twist. And this inversion is excellent. The inline twist is drawn out so you get some prolonged hang time through this inversion. It's my favorite inversion on the ride without a doubt. You then bank towards the ground and enter this 360 degree upward helix finale. The entrance into the helix has a really abrupt transition as you suddenly bank to the left, so this is another spot that can cause a jolt of headbanging if you're not careful. Unfortunately, this helix doesn't really offer any forces or laterals, so it's a bit of a dull way to end the ride. And to be honest, I sort of wish Untamed didn't have this helix. Untamed is the 320 Plus model. The Plus means that Untamed has a bonus helix at the end of the ride. Meanwhile, the 320 model, like Adrenaline Peak at Oaks Park or Hydrus at Casino Pier, forgo that helix and just pop into the brake run. And I actually prefer that finale. It removes the abrupt transition into the helix, and the pop into the brake run gives a teeny bit of airtime. So what would I rank Untamed? I would give this coaster a 6 out of 10. Untamed is a beautiful looking coaster, and it has some great elements with that beyond vertical drop and inline twist. But it's a short ride with some rough spots. As I mentioned earlier, make sure you lean forwards during the cutback, turnaround, and entrance into the helix, or you get some headbanging. Those are my thoughts on Untamed, Canobie Lake Park's bear-themed Eurofighter. What are your thoughts on Untamed, or the similar Eurofighters out there? I would love to hear your comments down below. If you enjoyed this review, I'd appreciate if you gave this video a like and consider subscribing, because there'll be a lot more roller coaster and amusement park videos here at Canobie Coaster. Thanks for listening.